Why President Donald Trump calls Melania his rack. President Donald Trump has made his deep affection for his wife Melania crystal clear, calling her his rock and his foundation in an email sent to supporters over the weekend. He also requested that recipients sign an online card to wish the First Lady a happy birthday. Family is one of life's most wonderful pleasures, and serving as America's first family has been a truly great privilege, said the email from the president. This month, our family is looking forward to a very special day. Please join us in celebrating the First Lady and my beautiful, kind-hearted and exceptional wife Melania's birthday by signing her card. The president continued, Melania is my rock and foundation, and I wouldn't be the man I am today without her by my side. The president also noted her devotion to their young son, Baron, 12. She's the cornerstone of our family, and an incredible mother to our son, Baron. I'm so proud of her accomplishments, and I hope you'll wish her well on her special day. The email, sent out officially by the Trump Make America Great Again Committee, also asked supporters for a campaign donation. The president is in rare company in touting the many attributes of his Slovenian-born wife, an accomplished and multilingual businesswoman in her own right. She's noted for being an exceptionally loving mother, but there is little mania for Melania among the mainstream press these days. While the media couldn't get enough of Michelle Obama's every move during her 8 years as First Lady, it is difficult if not impossible to find a major American magazine cover that features Melania Trump. There's a clear reluctance among editors to put themselves in the crosshairs of the culture wars, noted NBCNEWS.com. Recently, mostly New York-based editors may fear having to face unhappy readers or advertisers if they go with a choice so closely tied to President Donald Trump. The media once doggedly pursued balance, or at least gave the appearance of that. That's long gone these days. Some magazine editors may be putting politics ahead of money and vice versa, Samir Husni, director of the Magazine Innovation Center at the University of Mississippi, told NBC. Deirdre Riley is a senior editor at La Gazette,